Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Join Dota League playoffs. This, I believe, finally is the last match. I've been saying this on a number of the Join Dota League matches, so I could still be wrong. But this is a match which determines who goes through to the MLG Pro League, which, of course, is where all of these teams want to be. Fantastic tournament that happened over the weekend. Yeah, that's how you get into that, is by being in the Pro League and winning your division. Otherwise, you go back down to Division 2, which is still a fantastic place to be, lots of good teams, but not exactly the goal of all of these folks. So let's get right into it. Space Creators versus Mineski. I'm Llama Down Under. It's a solo cast. We're gonna try to keep it all excited because we're a bit lonely today, so. In other news, we've got an Undying first round ban. Not super unusual.
10 seconds remaining.
Just maybe not expecting that in place of something like the Slaughter or the SF. Again, I don't normally get the opportunity to call Sea Dota. It's normally done much earlier than this. This is pretty late for the players, I'm pretty sure. Oops, bumped my table. So it'll be interesting to see if the meta is significantly different than the European or North American or the American Dota I normally cast.
Dire team pick.
And yeah, we've got a Tusk ban out, a Doxia ban out, that makes a lot of sense. But the immediate Doom pickup, and then Mineski answer with Doom, with Tiny Io, like, that's rough for you, I have to say, if you're somebody else involved here. Like, I wouldn't want to be on Space Creator side. And another nice thing that Mineski has options for here is when your opponents pick a Doom, really the only strategy it seems to be that exists is you pick more cores than the Doom can Doom. Because if you have 3 cores or whatever, then how can Doom possibly Doom them all? Even if he does go the fast refresher build, he's gonna have trouble. So, oh, and let me just check something. Because I'm pretty sure I've set up some fancy, oh yeah, look at that. I don't actually know. Okay, it looks like the other stuff did change over. So now we're in Dota TV as well, and I believe I have my fancy casting settings on. I learned how to do my config files yesterday. There was actually a lot of grief with the config files, so. But yeah, it was a lot of fun. They had the Spirit Breaker. Spirit Breaker's pretty decent against Mineski, but Space Creator's probably a bit upset with them, or a bit irritated that they banned the Doxia essentially for Mineski, not knowing maybe that Mineski would pick up this
Radiant
combo.
Team
and a Dazzle ban as well. He just synergizes really well with the Io Tiny combo, making sure nobody has any mana buffing up Dire your team, keeping ban. Everybody alive. But also it becomes a bit of a pain when you're trying to kill someone with Doom if they constantly get saved by the Dazzle, or you have to waste your Doom on the Dazzle and then all of their cores just get away, which is a big pain. So a nice ban out there. So the Lich Hero, since Medallion and Solar Crest got nerfed, it feels like heroes that actually change armor have gotten more valuable, and the AA as well. Pretty obvious ban out from Mineski. You can see where the relocate is, so it's really easy to hit that Ice Blast. And Nightstalker being a fourth ban, we see him picked a lot earlier for us folks. And Mineski, wow, they are gonna have so much attack speed. Tiny, traditionally a hero who doesn't have any attack speed. You just don't have great opportunities to hit stuff because you're slow. That's why you need the Io with the Overcharge. But Beastmaster has the passive Inner Beast, which gives you quite a bit of attack speed. He also traditionally goes Necronomicon, which has an attack speed aura as well. So suddenly things looking really hard for Space Creators, just because this is a nice strategy. Now, this all depends on Mineski have to win their lanes, right? If Space Creators destroys the Io Tiny, if Beastmaster doesn't get off to a good spot, can't get any items, he's not going to have a great time. And the Disruptor pickup, not quite sure what this is about. I think a support which has a bit more lockdown seems a little bit better, but it's certainly something where Disruptor can stop the Witch Doctor's channel because you issue a stop command after that glimpse, or you can just drop Static Storm on their heads, and then good luck channeling. I'm not quite seeing how Mineski's plan is for grouping them up into that Static Storm, but you can certainly usually catch out one or two people with a Kinetic Field.
5 seconds remaining.
And the space creators, I'm pretty scared for whatever carry they pick. I'm assuming that's an offlane Doom, maybe paired with the Spirit Breaker also being a support. It could be a position 1 Doom or something, but not super sure though. It feels like a Bristleback. While this guy is naturally tanky, he certainly needs quite a few items to get there, so a bit concerned about him, to say the very least, but that's kind of how it goes when you're playing up against a
10 seconds remaining.
IO Tiny. Better to have tanky heroes. You can't always afford someone like the Spectre, who you might go otherwise, who is normally a super easy pickup. So.
Dire team banned.
And we've got Miss Wyvern banned out. Another good pick against the tiny IO. Of course, you can very easily catch both of them. And in that Winter's Curse. And then your tiny just kills off your IO. You cry a lot. Space creators, this Beastmaster could be mid, this Beastmaster could be offlane. I'd be worried about banning another good utility hero because I don't feel like Mineski needs more right click with just the tiny. Yes, it means that he might get doomed, but he can just stand there and fight a lot of the time, especially if the IO is there healing him up.
Radiant team pick.
Okay, so it's the Slaughter. That's another good hero that, oh goodness, imagining that amp damage with Tiny, who's already gonna hit like a truck here, that would not be fun. So I understand that pickup to a T. And
10 seconds remaining.
Going for probably on Mineski.
5 seconds remaining.
They could actually run a Sven really easily. It would make their lanes funky. But if they did the Beastmaster off lane and did a Sven in the safe lane, I think you'd have really strong lanes. It might be a bit greedy, but Beastmaster kind of farms a little bit differently than other people. Not sure what the plan would be. And then we've got, for space creators, I'm assuming this is a support Spirit Breaker. I really wouldn't like to see it be a core. And I'm assuming this is a safe lane Bristle. I'm not sure. Centaur does, yeah, Centaur's great here. Does something very similar to what Slaughter does, where they have extra AoE damage. And of course that Centaur ult. They already had the IO relocate. Maybe a relocate goes south. They Centaur stampede them out. Maybe they can't quite catch someone. They stampede them in. It's a really flexible pickup, so seems pretty good
remaining.
To say the least.
5 seconds remaining.
And yeah, let me just fix that up.
Reserve time.
For space creators, I'm not liking this draft. I worry about Bristlecore. I'm trying to think of what else would be damn fantastic for them. They've got a little bit of minus armor going on. Maybe they could buff that up. Maybe they just want a strong mid laner here, in which case I think TA is generally decent against an IO Tiny. You still have a hard time, but I think it's better than a lot of options. You could also try for a Venno mid. It's not super, super traditional, but you have a bit more tools to deal with a tiny IO than maybe some other lanes.
Lina.
And it's the Lina. I mean, yeah, if she hits a like strike array on both, but not looking great otherwise. And getting pretty worried about this. I have to say, I'm much more in favor of the draft of space creators here. I'm not sure I'm loving Mineski's. I'm not sure I'm loving space creators lineup. I think Mineski's is quite a bit stronger. But of course, it's all going to come down to how these lanes go. And the Bristleback might be able to get big enough that the IO Tiny combo maybe doesn't come online if they don't get early kills.
10 seconds remaining.
So, after the players finally pick up all of their stuff,
seconds remaining.
We will see what exactly goes down there. And yeah, this'll be it. We're paused. Aw, yes. But I'm pretty sure, aw, yeah. Tried out my new config files, just gonna brag a bunch about them. I think also, okay, my shift key also does something now, but I don't know what it does, so I have to reread that. I bound it to something and I hadn't practiced, so. Okay, I have a fun bug here. I don't know if you guys like to see heroes, but apparently I don't. It's not important though. Who needs to actually see who the heroes are? We've got N on that witch doctor, KZ on Bristleback, disappointed face, maybe just questioning face on that Doom, Godot on Lena, and finally Lynn on that Spirit Breaker. On Mineski, we've got Cuckoo on the Tiny. Oh wow, look at this background. Yeah, that's some good stuff. You don't always see that. Disruptor on Cackle? It's almost like that. Io, who's somehow all the way over there, being played up by Potato. Raging Potato. Beastmonster headed out to the Southland by Ryor. Gosh, I'm butchering these names. And finally up top center, played by Jesse. So, not quite sure. Not quite sure who everyone is. Once again, I don't normally do the C Dota. But we'll take a look around. See if we've got anything cool and early spotted out. And actually already got something here. Godot. Is that a support, Lena? And a core Spirit Breaker? Ooh. Okay, not super in love with this. They're gonna get scouted by the boar this entire rotation. Not gonna work out for them. These portraits gonna drive me insane. Let me see. Sometimes that fixes it. It did not fix it. I probably won't restart for that, but if we get a nice opportunity to restart, we'll fix the portraits. Although there was a patch, so maybe it's just the patch being broken. I love it. I don't know if it's Godot.
The battle begins.
I think Godot sounds silly. Why would a T be silent? We're Australians. But yeah, I'll try to say it Godot if other people confirm. So. And let's take a look around. Looking up at these lanes, bottom lane. I think I would maybe favor this lane to the Lena Spirit Breaker combo. And taking a look in mid, Bristleback. I think I understand what they're trying to do here. It sounds like they're trying to do the Bristleback. Oh gosh, Courier! It's gonna be fine. I think the hopes was that the Bristleback spines will hit both of them and just be more painful to the rest of the folks. But pretty sure Bristle's gonna get beaten up in this lane. In bottom, I actually favor the Spirit Breaker Lena lane. I think they have an easy setup for stuns. Yes, there's a glimpse back potentially, but I really just like the synergy to go on this Disruptor whose portrait is missing. At the same time, Beastmonster, this boar is deceptively a pain in the ass. This boar can just slow people down and you're like, please stop hitting me with your stupid piercing boar, because it has piercing. And that's a dead boar, never mind. Forgot about that interaction. There they are, going on the Disruptor. Lightstrike Ray hits. They don't have the Dragon Slayer because they just used it on the boar, but they have it now, and that's going to be our first blood. Well played, Godot. Whose name I'm still judgy about.
Gonna be a scorch.
So, that's the synergy I was talking about, and we were even in the right lane to see it. Going to be a good start. I also really like them putting a little bit of farm onto the Lena. I think she can. She's a hero that, one, can flash farm particularly well. She getting that Ags up, it's just something where even with the nerf to Aghanim's, Ags Refresher is still broken on Lena. I mean, how many heroes? Tiny's gonna have a lot of health because of course he rushes Aghanim's, but Lena can dish out 1700 damage in less than 3 seconds. Very few heroes, even with an Io, can really deal with this. So. And yeah, Witch Doctor is back. The Doctor is back. So, we'll see. Once again, just because we're paused, I'll say it. This is the Joint Dota League playoff finals of Mineski versus Space Creators. I'm Llama Down Under. It's a solo cast. I would love your feedback on how to get better. We'll get into that later, so. Taking a look over at mid lane, Bristleback, or Bristlebong as we sometimes affectionately refer to him, has one CS. I do think as levels go by he'll have a better time, but with a ranged hero, while the IO is off stacking, you can sometimes get some harassment onto Bristleback. Instead, they're getting the best of both worlds for Mineski. They're getting to stack, and the Bristleback, and their Tiny is getting all the CS in the world because the Bristleback can't zone him. So, a bit painful there. On the other hand, Doom will farm up a storm safely. Oh, we're starting to see some hero portraits. Do you guys see this? That's funky. Oh, we actually see it on. They're coming in. They're coming in, guys. The hero portraits. So, we're gonna be seeing the Doom get very big. Devour gives you a lot of extra gold. I just don't know if it's enough against an IO Tiny combo. And we've got another charge. They hit the Light Strike Array. One more auto attack. Another kill for Godot. Although at the same time, I miss Bristleback going down mid. It looks like Tiny just comboed him. I'm not even sure if the IO was there. Okay, the fight recap didn't catch it. No. So, IO doesn't have spells on cooldown. Tiny, I think, just used Toss Avalanche and yeah, that's what happens to you when you're Bristleback at early levels. Now, I think this Disruptor just food down here. I think, yeah, doing the right thing now. Should just lost hit with the ball. Going on Bristlebong again. Can they get the balls out far enough to hit him? One to the face, two. Oh, they gotta pull him in a little bit, Io. You know what? Yeah, it's gonna be fine. He's gonna, actually Bristle doing a good job of dodging these. I have not seen such fantastic ball dodging in a long time. Io is now showing up. But still not other people, so a little bit unlucky there. And KZ can just walk it off. I like that he's picked up the magic wand early. Oh gosh, now they're just going on the Beastmaster. It's the same deal. Beastmaster's a little bit more tanky. He might just need to stack up on regen here, or play really far back, letting the boar last hit. Witch Doctor taking quite a bit of damage. Oh gosh, here comes the stun, and I'm pretty sure N is DC'd. Yeah. That's awkward. That's always not how you want to start your day off, you know? Not exactly the best to have an BDC'd. It's rough. It's really quite rough. And lots of pauses here. Hope it doesn't mean I miss my next set, but just taking a look around the map, I think a slight lead for Space Creators. Most of this is negligible. It's really just the Lina has got two kills. She's farming really well. The Tiny is still beating her out, but this is a support Lina who has four lost hits and so is very high up. The Spirit Break is actually the farmer, and I think this feels like a decent game for a Blade Mail. It also just feels like a good game for a BKB so that he can go in and keep bashing and not have to worry about being avalanched or tossed. Especially avalanched or tossed away from his allies. So. And Jesse is going to be getting a kill here, most likely.
User was moved to your channel.
So, and apparently I'm in TeamSpeak and not in the right channel. Let me just fix channel that up. Switch. Please ignore the unprofessionalism of a llama. There we go. So, taking a look around, let's see if we got anything fancy going on. And, I don't see any particularly good item pickups from folks. I feel so sorry for N here. This is like, and they're probably not gonna let him escape. It does feel a bit like it's too value. You can't just let someone escape like that. Sentai also has his tranquils up. He's not doing poorly himself. I was expecting him to maybe have a bit more trouble, but of course with Witch Doctor roaming about, does he at least, it looks like he pulled these stacks, so he doesn't even have extra stacks up. Bristleback's actually really effective at doing stacks, so a little bit questionable. The Witch Doctor isn't making those. At the same time, always good to get your sleigh on, and maybe Witch Doctor thinks that's a better use of his time. The Lena could also hear, if they end up turning it into a 1v1, lane bottom, because maybe the Disruptor decides, if I go back here, I'm just going to keep dying, let me leave. It's entirely possible that they could try to, or I think would be a nice thing to do, is have the Lena stack the Ancients repeatedly. It just feels like a good spot for her. She can go maybe rotate middle with a smoke. She already has arcanes. Clearly getting level 4, a little bit more damage output, either by picking up Fiery Soul or another point in that Light Strike array, would be fantastic. So, and yeah, we're still paused. I don't know what to say. Pause gaming. Everybody's, oh, he's back. Let's get back into watching the sad, slow demise of N. I really don't know what to say about it. It's like, you're dead. You're very dead, bro. So, we make uncomfortable sounds. They're ready to go. He knows he's going down, and he's gonna finish taking that avalanche. Take a few more and take the toss. And yeah, both teams understanding that you can't just give up a kill like that. So, kind of unfortunate. It feels like Space Creator's only hope is to shut down this tiny IO lane, and they're certainly not doing it here. There's gonna be a glimpse back, Bristlebong. He's in the wrong position. He's gonna take all those balls, but luckily the- Oh, it's back off cooldown, I was just about to say. He's gonna toss the IO on him. Can he save his teammate? No, he gets the coconuts, but it's not gonna be enough. Just doing a little bit of damage. That's a level 1 coconut. So, also really interesting that Witch Doctor is maxing Voodoo and not something else. The charge cancelled from Spirit Breaker, because he realizes that folks are all healed up. And maybe their job down here just has to be, maybe they just have to 100% go for killing off this lane over and over. It's one of their easiest targets, the Disruptor. The IO also good targets, but being in mid with the Tiny, and look at these stacks, this is disgusting. I need to learn how to do this. It's beautiful. We've got a charge, though. He's not going to see this until it's too late. Here comes the Eagle. Can the Light Strike array hit, though? It is. Just gets the edge. But do they have enough damage? She had put more points. Oh, gosh. They get it with the Bash. I was about to say, maybe more points in Fiery Soul would have paid the way there. But no, they don't need it. And now another TP in. Does Tiny have any sort of stuff? He does have the Avalanche Toss combo. They need to be very careful here. But the Lena, thinking about coming in. I really thought the Lena was going to be mid initially, just because it's not easy, but it's feasible to hit those Dragon Slaves on the tethered up unit. And if they can get anything on Tiny here, but at the same time, he is very scary. Godot, only rocking Arcanes. You really have to be careful there. So, and, Casey not even feeling safe enough to go close up to the creep wave. So, not my favorite way to see a Bristleback playing. They just knock out the creep wave and they're gone. Now, Doom up here as well, I was really hoping he'd be able to do more. He is level 6, maybe thinking about when he can rotate, maybe he'll rush a blink. It's got a really big wind-up, the Doom, so it's hard to go on a lot of these heroes, but he should be able to catch a few. IO is being charged. I don't know if they're going to continue this. They are. Lena's here. Is she 6? No, she's just level 5. So the charge is going to be through. They're going to kill off IO. Maybe they need like 3 more auto attacks, but he's bottling up, regenerating so quickly. Spirit Break is going for it, but he's going to be stuck on the tether. He has the Nether Strike, but he can't get in vision, and he's just going to go down. And now the glimpse back on the Bristleback. Suddenly they're on the back foot. 3 seconds until both of these spells are on cooldown. A beautiful Light Strike array. Bristle, maybe. Oh, he doesn't have any points in Nasal Goo. And Lena's just going to go down here, taking the combo. Doesn't even need the bloody combo. He does decide to use it for style points. So, really unfortunate there. Witch Doctor DCs again. It's not looking great. I think that you've got to be very worried here if you're Mineski. You're kind of losing all of your lanes, to say the least. It looks like only a small gold lead for Mineski, but I'm pretty sure after those kills, it's gonna come out as much bigger. Oh gosh, and And the fact that you haven't even killed off this solo centaur, he got a bit of a buff on the return damage, but he's still not a fantastic offlaner without support. And not making enough space. Io, is this gonna be another bloody stack? Oh my gosh, okay, he doesn't quite get it. He almost dies to neutrals. It's what a way to be. He's just softening it up for Tiny, it looks like. And Doom. He does actually, he doomed the centaur up there, but it didn't do nearly enough damage. Finally, Witch Doctor picking up a point in that Voodoo Restoration. Will it be enough is the real question, though. This guy is so squishy, and the Tiny going to be coming online much earlier than we expected, just because, one, he has uncontested form, and now he has 5 kills involvement. So. And apparently is making weird tiny sounds. So we can see he's got treads, he's got a casual bracer, probably going to be a drums. It does really good stats when you are tiny. And Bristleback doesn't even have his treads. We've got movement as if a charge. It's a smoke. Coming out of Space Creators, they have to try and do something here. If they can catch out the tiny. Oh gosh, they're even stacking the ancients. Mineski's farm game is on point, and I'm pretty sure they'll charge up Disruptor here, maybe get something, but Doom, he's going down. Nothing's gonna save him. Sentinel's just gonna Sentinel Warrunner Stomp. Oh, he calls the Doom, but here comes Tiny, here comes Io. Where are the TP support? There's gonna be a toss. Doom needs to walk it off. He does have that regen. He's healing up a storm, but here's gonna be the Io relocating. Doom needs to get the hell out of there, and he is caught up. There is no escape here. Toss gonna kill him off. Where are our supports? Here's gonna be the charge. Tiny tries to stop it, but he can't. Charge gonna hit. Can he get the bashes? They're going in on Tiny now. He's just gonna pick off N. A nice Maledict combo. There's gonna be another strike, but N is already dead, and Tiny, he doesn't care about this Maledict. He is just gonna kill you off. He is healing up. Where are the support rotations from Space Creators? And they just don't have any. Charge away. Lena thinking about doing something. She does have the Laguna Blade. She can pick one of these. Light Strike Array? No, Dragon Slave. She's gonna pick off the Io, and that is fantastic for them. Do they have anything for the Tiny? The charge should be on cooldown for a few more seconds. And they don't have enough mana to use it. So they're gonna go for a charge onto middle. Oh, they're going for the Disruptor. Can they kill him? It's a Centaur, not the Disruptor. My mistake. Thought Disruptor was still hanging out in mid lane, but they cancel the charge. And now the Spirit Breaker. Okay, they can't see him. Never mind. So finally, Space Creator is getting another set of kills, but again, Tiny, he got another 2 kills there. One on the Doom, one on the Witch Doctor. Now he's gonna kill a Bristle Bomb, tossing him backwards, making sure these balls hit him in the face. There's a charge, but I don't know if Tiny cares. They miss the Io with that skill. The kinetic field doesn't latch, though. There is a glimpse backwards. Maybe they can finally kill off Tiny. The Bristle does manage to kill off the Disruptor. Oh gosh, Bristle, you're so low, bottling up. But if balls hit you in the face, you may just go down. No! Bristle dies to the balls. They're trying to go back on Io. Lena has no more mana, even though Laguna Blade's coming off cooldown soon. Nothing they can do. They're gonna kill off Spirit Breaker, and Lena just watches as her ally dies, and they relocate. Are they going bottom? Are you kidding? Doom, he's gonna go down now. Tiny doesn't care that he's doomed up, and Doom just taking it to the face. Oh, Bristleback coming back in here, but the relocate gonna save both of them. He can't even catch up Mr. Beastmaster. What a fantastic series of plays for Mineski. And that team fight. There was the buyback on Bristle, getting nothing done because the relocate sent them home. Now it looks like Top taking a lot of damage. This is N is dead again. Dire's top tower is under attack. So, Mineski looking very dominant in this game one. Probably about 5,000 gold ahead when all of these things settle down. Middle tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack. So. And in middle lane, oh gosh, we have a charge coming in. What's going on there? There's going to be a storm popping up. They're tossing her back into the static storm, Lena. Oh, can she juke? But the tower hit. She does pop her one more auto attack, and the tower gets her. Devastating there for Lena. And now Tiny. He's... Holy cow, he's going to have a 14-minute Aghanim Scepter. Maybe faster with this tower kill. See if Bristleback can do anything. They do have the charge up. Netherstrike is active as well. The avalanche stops them both dead, but oh, they have no high ground vision. So, Disruptor places a ward. They saw that on Space Creators, but I don't know if they have the farm on anyone to buy sentries. Yeah, Witch Doctor Tupor, where are we going into? They're charging up the centaur. Lena could maybe flash farm up some sentries. There's gonna be a charge anyway, though. There's a relocate coming in. They're gonna have to use this nether strike. Well, the avalanche toss combo, it's killing off both of them. And the Doom, he doesn't even want to be involved here. He has Scorched Earth up to maybe try and escape, but if he's not careful. And that is Tiny's Aghanim's, pretty much. There's gonna be the toss. There's the Centaur stomp. Avalanche back up in three. Doom onto Centaur, but I don't think you wanted to Doom him down. There's the avalanche, and Doom goes down. Tiny is 8-0 and 7. This is ridiculous. And the Centaur's taking no damage from this Doom.
Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
There's gonna be the toss combo. Tiny.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Wow, this. Oh, Tiny has the Ags on its way to him. 12 minutes in. Has an Ags. Already making good progress on a Blink Dagger. So, and they managed to pick somebody off. The Beastmaster goes down. Oh, but the Witch Doctor falls to the last right click of the boar. Spiritbreaker couldn't kill off that boar in time, and happens to the best of us. So. Now, we've had a huge amount of action. I don't know what Space Creators can do to get back into this, but let's brainstorm, folks. We gotta take a look around. They've got a smoke up. There are still people they can kill on the lineup of Mineski. Disrupt is squishy. Io is squishy. The problem is catching Io out alone. And so, maybe you find somebody here. Maybe you catch someone unawares and you manage to get a pickoff. So, and see what they manage to do. Spiritbreaker also, he didn't manage to tone. He actually did at one point have good gold. Wow, and if we look at this net worth chart, this really is just the story of the game. Four members of Mineski, higher net worth than all of the members of Space Creators. And as I'm saying, I think the Spiritbreaker, he had a great lane down bottom. He and Lina were killing up a storm. But they just have nothing really to counter this Tiny 10,000 net worth lead for that lineup. 5,000, probably getting closer to the 7,500 experience lead, just because Mineski feels like they can take objectives and Space Creators can't. And already got level 1 Necronomicon. We talked about this, the combos that are going to come out. Beastmaster, he's putting points into his inner beast over the wild axes, and they see it in their sights to finish this game. They're going to use that Primal Roar onto Bristleback. A little bit surprised they don't go for more. There is a charge out onto Disruptor, but there's going to be just a Static Storm set up. Is there going to be anything from Witch Doctor? He's just dead before he can Death Ward. Coconuts are bouncing around, but it is not enough. Doom has finally doomed somebody up. There's a Laguna Blade as well, but I don't even know if Centaur will tick down at this point to that Doom, and they're just wrecking. Doom, baby Dooms pop out, but they have no sort of defense, and that's also going to be, Centaur does finally die to Doom, but Godot, he's going down, and I wouldn't be surprised if Space Creators just call it. Over 15,000 net worth behind at 15 minutes in. And Mineski just going to turn this into an easy tower. It's not like the Doom and Bristleback come online a little bit later or something. It's not like you can say, hey, we've got a Medusa, we've got another late game hero where we can just really wait things out. Space Creators don't really have another option. If they didn't get online early, it feels like you're against a Tiny IO. Your build, it doesn't work. Level 2 Necronomicon gonna be coming out on Beastmaster soon, and he is very close to level 3. Those things hit like a truck. If you kill them, everybody I think on this lineup will receive... Oh, nice charge away. Well played, Spiritbreaker. The level 3 Necronomicons do too much damage. I think it's 500 pure or something. Where does it say? Lost will damage. 800! I'm sorry. 800 lost will damage on that warrior. You can't kill that. That straight up just... Lina, like, is almost dead. Witch Doctor dies if he kills the Necro Creep.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Now they're gonna go for a trade here. Space Creators gotta do what they can. They've gotta really go for... they've gotta really go for a tower here. And if they can get this, it's something. So it's... I mean, it sounds bad, right? But it's something. It's kind of all space creators can go for. The net worth chart not looking as bad as it did a second ago with Centaur going down to the Doom. And in mid lane, no, who is this charge on? Who are you charging? Are you charging an illusion? Okay. That's unfortunate, but it's fine. You knew it was an illusion. You're just trying to get across the map. And getting a tower for a space creator is huge.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
It's not going to really stop this lead, but it's going to put a dent in it. Tiny, getting close. It could be Sandra and Yasha. It could be Manta. I think Manta's cute here because it procs off a few things, but either of them, I really would have preferred to see him go the Blink and have him go Morham, especially since he has just picked up this Aegis, although it is going to be reclaimed soon. For Mineski, if you really just want to close out this game, you probably just want to push down more tier 2s, make sure there's no way back in it. Although ganking up Bristleback will be good enough. Now there's going to be the Primal Roar, the Relocate in, Toss Avalanche combo! And as it says, holy shit, Doom is going to get glimpsed off to the side, but they're ready there! Centaur coming in, and that's a very dead Doom! Nothing he can do before the double edge comes out. So. Lina farming up in bottom lane. She is getting close, actually, to the Aghanims. So.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
And Tiny, not quite revealing whether this is a Sandra and Yasha or a Manta, but good either way. Just gonna work on this tier 4. He has to be a bit careful here. The Aegis is expiring in a minute. They charge in on him, but there is an IO. Coconuts don't even bounce to the heroes. Finally bouncing to Tiny, but it is not something he has to worry about. Tower already down to a fourth of its health. It's going down. They don't have anything to stop him. They need to pump so much into him, but this is still first life. And now he's working on the melee racks. They charge in on the back lines, but they get stunned up first. Static Storm. Oh gosh, it's caught the Witch Doctor, and that's a very dead body. No chance at Death Ward. Bristleback trying to go in on the back lines. They need something to stop off Tiny. Doom actually tanks all of the will from that creep, and they might be able to kill off Tiny. No, doesn't feel like they have enough damage, but they've got the IO. Glimpse back actually gonna help out Mr. Spirit Breaker. That was very close on the Tiny. He's happy with that. They'll kill off IO as well. Just need one more auto attack. They get it. That's huge for them. But now Tiny's in their base. He's gonna get the tower with the toss. Do they have anything else? They need to slow him down. Spirit Breaker, no, he's in range at those auto attacks, which don't feel like they're melee. Taking a stun to the face, gonna be a toss as well. Can Tiny just do this 1v4? Looks like he can. Doesn't even need his team. There are the coconuts. Finally, the Death Ward. First Death Ward of the game, and Tiny may finally go down. They need to keep doing damage to him. IO isn't back yet. He's not taking enough from the Maledict. And Tiny's just gonna walk it off. So they lose a melee Rax, and they don't get... I mean, they got the IO kill, which was huge for them. We missed it, but... approaching a 20,000 net worth lead for Mineski, and not looking like, for this game at least, there's a way for them to get back into it. Now, Tiny has a full AC. That was a casual Yasha. That was a I'd like to move faster and do more damage Yasha. Sorry, an attack faster Yasha. It... not looking great. And not that they've been worried about the armor, the minus armor coming out of Bristleback on this viscous nasal goo, but if they were worried about it, they don't have to be. So. Disruptor, Glimmer Cape, Io also Glimmer Caped up. Beast Monster got that level 3 Necronomicon that we saw doing so much damage with their, it's called like Death Will? Yes. Warrior lost will damage. So. And they're just gonna deward casually. And see what they can do there. So. Let's see if we've got anything new. Lina, oh, she's so close to her Aghanims. It's going to be pure damage. It might help them pop the Io. Io isn't rocking a lot of health yet, so.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
It's certainly something. Oh, who are they? They're not going on anyone. And taking a look around, Assange, you're trying to tank up desperately on the Bristleback, but I think this,
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
The Vlad, not Vlad's, Vanguard. It's too little too late. You go Vanguard if you can get it early, otherwise it just doesn't give you a lot of stuff, and the Crimson Guard here not feeling fantastic. Again, Tiny with the AC, with the overcharge. These towers are melting. Is that a 5-shot I see? They've got a charge out, but Glimmer caped up IO. He melts Spirit Break. I didn't even see how he died. The coconut's even gonna be... Where's the Witch Doctor ult? He doesn't have mana for it. He pops his wand, but he goes down. Godot's gonna take one more auto attack, gets off a beautiful Light Strike Array, but do they have anything for him? Doom is sent backwards, and there... They still haven't called it. The Bristleback taking a lot of damage. Let's see whether they can actually catch him. It looks like the Thunderclap. They don't need it. Auto attacks coming out from Beastmaster, and they're gonna get all of the racks here. They actually hadn't finished off bottom racks, but it is down. A mech even, for good measure. 22 minutes in. Over a 1,000 net worth lead per minute on Mineski. They can rotate top. They can go for the towers. I imagine that Space Creators right now, all they're doing is they're just thinking about ways to draft better or get back into next game. And Witch Doctor tries to Witch Doctor ult, but a Ghost Scepter picked up. They're killing people in the fountain. Tiny doesn't care. The GG is finally cold. Tiny may go down to the fountain, but he doesn't care as long as he gets... Oh no! It's stolen from him! So. That's gonna be it. And, yeah. It's... A dominating performance by Bineski, I think is the best way to say it. Not too much else, really, getting out there. Now, once again, I'm on the Down Under. I would love your feedback on how to get better. Solo costs, always a little bit difficult. I'll try to get us into game 2 right quick. We might have to disconnect in between to see what I can do about that faces bug. But we might just be going no faces all game. So let's go to some music and the splash screen. Thank you all so much for watching. I'd love to hear your feedback on Llama Down Under Twitter, Facebook, all of those magical places where you can leave me feedback on how to become a better caster. Road to TI 27. Let's get into it.